business trip.
Do the people move around?
It does tingle a little bit.
So, since I got accused of planting last week's top three, there's nothing in my hands.
You're the only one reading the sheet. Nobody else can see the topic list.
Well, here. I'll cover your face with the topics.
There we go. Here's the screen share, folks.
Do-do-do-do-do. Top three topics. Bam. Right there. There's our top three topics. All right. Pulling one out.
They all say the same thing.
We have number six this week.
You literally draw number six like every time.
No, I do not. Number six this week, and that is going to be your top three favorite pools at Walt Disney World. And you have, hold on a second, 20 seconds.
Planning your first trip and getting overwhelmed by all the details? Planning your next trip and just want some new suggestions on things you haven't tried? Contact me at Princess of the Mouse Travel, and I'd love to work with you planning your next trip to the most magical place on Earth.
You can contact Princesses and the Mouse Disney Travel on Facebook at PATM Disney Travel.
It's a great start. It's awesome when I just click off my thing. I click off my screen and all of a sudden everything goes to hell. So, all right. Do you want to go first or you want me to go first?
Doesn't matter, but you know what my number one is. And if you take it, I'm coming through the computer.
Yeah. Yeah, I do know what your number one is. And it's not even going to make my top three.
That's amazing. Yeah. All right. So my number one, I am going to start...
We're going to start with number three, though.
Oh, yeah. So my first one, also known as number three, is going to be the pool over at Polynesian. Really, really quality pool. Water slide is really fun. And just kind of everything about it, just because of the decor, and the splash pad and the climbing up the rocks to come down the slide, just and the zero entry on the back end, the bar over to the side, just kind of. And then the best part is looking out of the pool. The castle is in the background right across the lake. At nighttime, you can just kind of lounge in the pool and they will pipe the music in from the fireworks show. So lay in the pool, watch the fireworks show, hear the music from the park piped in to the area, just kind of everything about it. And then just the decor of the Polynesian being all tropical oasis just kind of sets you on that tropical vacation mode. And so really, really enjoy the times that I've been able to swim in the Polynesian pool and just kind of spend some time in and around that area. So that is going to be my number three.
All right. Well, my number three is going to be the big blue pool at Art of Animation. So great pool for kids. Big walk-in splash area. Good theming to Finding Nemo / Finding Dory. Speakers underwater. Just a really fantastic pool if you want to spend some time there. And you know what we fail to talk about is we're really highlighting like the main pool at a resort in most cases. In a lot of these resorts, there are 2, 3, 4 different pools that you get to choose from. So like Art of Animation and Pop Century each have 3 pools, and that's a pretty cool thing to think about, that you're not, everybody's not trying to go into one pool. So my pool number 3 is the big blue pool at Art of Animation. So what is your number 2?
The big blue pool. My number 2 is going to be the pool, the main pool, as Matt just kind of mentioned, over at Caribbean Beach. So that is the Fuentes del Morro pool over at Caribbean Beach. fantastic. It is themed after a Spanish fort that is like under siege. So some of the walls have like bits blown out of it from cannon fire and all that stuff. What makes this pool absolutely great, kind of the similar thing, it's up in the front by the main building. You have this big poolside bar that also has like a little eatery attached to it. You're close to the main building, so you can go in and grab a go order out of the marketplace. And then you can just set up camp in this pool during the day. There's plenty of like events that your kids can go, trivia, all, you know, all sorts of games. Big splash area, good size slide, a hot tub back behind the more kind of like a secluded hot tub, makes it more like an adult oasis back behind the hustle and bustle of the main pool. And then just a little side slide as well. So definitely my favorite intermediate pool over there at Caribbean Beach, because you just, again, great place to just take a day off and just spend like 4 or 5 hours there, and you will have a great time the whole time you're there.
Yeah, my number two is I'm going to go to a deluxe resort, and I'm going to go to the main pool at the Contemporary Resort. When you get into your deluxe resorts, a lot of them will have water slides and that kind of stuff. Another pool with a water slide. It's more of a classic style pool, but what makes it really fun is the things that they do around the pool. They've got trivia, they've got music, they've got all kinds of things going on all the time, just like you would have at like your weekend neighborhood pool. But it's behind the Contemporary, and it's back there on the bay, and just really nice area and really cool pool to spend some time in. Really got to spend a lot of time at it the COVID year when we got stuck at the Contemporary for a few days. And really got to enjoy that pool for a good amount of time. So that is my number two, the pool at Contemporary Resort. Let's go to our number one choices.
So Matt already knows what my number one is going to be. It is the shared pool between the Yacht and Beach Club. So here's the thing about this pool. With all of the different features that I'm about to mention, it actually has to be registered with the state of Florida as a water park. So it is officially registered as a water park. Here is the amazing thing about this pool. You have to walk across the walkway coming out of Epcot to get to this big spiral staircase to start this water slide. So if you pay attention as you're walking down that path, you'll see a big brown tube going a couple stories above the path. That is the water slide. So the water slide shoots you through this tube and then pops out into openness. And then you go through a couple of little waterfalls and then you splash down. And if that wasn't enough, there's another little slide over there in the shipwreck. And if that's not enough, there is a whirlpool area where they've got the jets angled in such a way that you will literally just keep going around in a circle if you let your body free float. There is a volleyball area. There are multiple hot tubs. I believe there's 3 hot tubs. There is a lazy river, and there is a sand bar where kids can like play in the sand inside of the pool, and a bunch of the pool is sand bottomed. So you just have this like massive play area, and it is just such a unique pool experience, and it is one of the main reasons that, and being able to walk into the backside of Epcot, the pool and walking into the backside of Epcot is the reason why Yacht and or Beach Club are my top resorts on all of Disney property, because of just the amazing experience. When you stay at those resorts, you have to fight your kids to go to the parks because they would rather just be back doing that.
Yeah, Stormalong Bay is the name of the area.
Sorry, I forgot to say Stormalong Bay.
All right, my number one, before we get to that, if you have made it this far in the video, definitely hit that like button, subscribe to the channel. And if you want to submit an idea for a top three, go to our website, patmdisneytravel.wixsite.com/planning, and check out the little box up in the top right corner, and it will let you suggest topics for this and our client question section of the shows. So definitely do that. My number one, we've gotten to do it once, and it is the pool at Riviera. Riviera, the brand new resort, is absolutely fantastic in a lot of different ways. But their pool area, not only do they have a huge deluxe style pool with water slides and all that kind of stuff, their secondary pool is awesome. They've got a bocce ball court. That whole little area where the pools are is unbelievable. And it's a great place to just, again, waste a day and not go to the parks. You've been there. Have you enjoyed the pools at the Riviera?
Yeah, I actually thought about going to Riviera, but I felt like that was a cop-out since, you know, most of our viewers know that that's where my DVC is at. Yeah, it's beautiful because there's a couple of kind of porch swings, and like you mentioned, the bocce pit. There's a chess set. The quiet pool just off to the side is kind of a shallower pool, so it's really nice to just sort of lounge around in. Zero entry on the main pool, hot tub, really nice water slide. Yeah, all fantastic stuff at Riviera for sure. Worthy of a number one. Like I said, I didn't want to take it as a cop. Oh, of course you'd pick Riviera. It's your own.
Well, I mean, but if you went Riviera, I was going Yacht and Beach Club. So it didn't matter. Our number ones were going to be the same no matter what.
Yeah, it's just a question of which one you bring up for sure.
Yeah. All right. Again, if you have one that you like better than the ones we talked about today, definitely put it down in the comments, put it in the chat, let us know. And if you want to submit a question or an idea for the top three, patmdisneytravel.wixsite.com/planning and fill out the form in the top right corner. Peter, how can people find you?
Facebook. Just type Disney Travel Agent or Princess and the Mouse, and you will find me and my family standing in front of Expedition Everest until I change the photo that I mention every week. Because my kids are like 4 years out of date. But yep, that's the easiest way to find me, and then we'll get talking about your amazing vacation and everything that I can do for you.
And as long as you're doing a package or staying at the going to the parks for more than 3 days, it is at no cost to no additional cost to you. So
it's at no cost to you.
All right, Peter. Hey, thanks for checking us out today. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons to help out the channel. Also, if you're looking for some more Disney content, check this out. I think you're gonna like it.